all of the times I've been there, times I came through. I'd meet you anywhere if it brought me closer to you.
Once upon a time, on Saying It As It Is with Chiriki Inspirations, and I'm back with another juicy episode on trending updates of Queen and Queen David. If you don't know, there are other videos of Queen's marriage and her relationship saga. And here I'm back with an update, an interesting, popping, juicy update that you all want to listen to. Now you see, the storyline of Queen is something that every woman needs to learn from, right? And the storyline of Lord Lamba and King David is a storyline that every young man needs to learn from, whether you're single or married. Now let's take it off from how Queen and her husband are showering and exploding every timeline back to back with loads and loads of videos, like videos of their love experience in their marriage, in their civil wedding. You know, after the traditional marriage, we thought it was going to end there. Little did we know that they are going to take it up to the next level of sealing it up legally. Wow, little will you expect that, but as intelligent and wise as they are, they took it up to that next step of sealing it up legally. They signed it legally. You can see videos of them deeply expressing their love publicly online. Like, who cares? Like, I don't know. If you know the backstory of Queen, if you have watched the video, you will know that there's one thing about Africans when it comes to a single mother. Like, once you have a baby outside wedlock, the target to be that yours is written off, or you have little to slim chances of finding love again and settling down. But no, it wasn't the same for Queen. And why is it like that for Queen? Everyone around Queen, everyone who knows Queen personally, can attest to the fact that Queen is a sweet soul, Queen is a sweetheart. It cannot be the same for everyone finding love, right? Finding love for a second time after having a baby or babies as a single mom. Based off, one, your personality, your character, and your perception to relationship and love. That's one thing. But when you look at it or liken it to the case of Queen, you will know that Queen is a sweet soul, no cap. Her personality, her character speaks love, it speaks care, it speaks affection. In fact, I don't know, for someone like Queen, there's every 101 possibility of making a good wife, a good mother, and a good home. No cap. I know it's not going to be easy. The challenges are going to be there, because it's never been easy when it comes to relationship and marriage. But I believe she has all it takes when it comes to wisdom, knowledge, understanding, and the physical energy, strength God has given it to her. So we give it to her 100%. Like, we give it to her 99%. Okay, so everyone, down to King's family, down to Queen's friends, have a thing or two positively to say about Queen. And I believe this is why it is raining love, it is raining sweet, it is raining blessings, showers of love, showers of blessings to Queen. And I know, on the other hand, for King David, despite what, regardless of what he saw or what happened in between the course of his relationship with Queen along the line, and Queen got distracted like we also, and had a baby for, you know, a side dude, it was totally fine, and he saw more reasons why he should go back and take the bull by the horn by doing the needful. And let it be on record that no woman is yours until you have put a ring on it and done the needful. It is only then you can now say, as a man, that this woman is yours. Anything you are doing with a woman, whether baby comes in or not, is just mere relationship. It's just on the mere face of it. It only becomes real, strengthened, legal, recognized, and accepted by the family and by the general public when you, as a man, tie the knot officially, legally. You know, when it comes to Christian wedding or whatever, traditionally, that is when you can now say, yes, this woman is completely yours when it comes to marriage, okay? Not yours as an object when it comes to marriage, okay? Now, having cleared that, the internet has been feeling pity for the state of Lord Lamba, to the point that, in fact, it has become a caricature to him. You see that singular mistake that he made, thinking he was the almighty God, the one who knows it all, who can determine a woman's life. Yes, she has a baby now, her life is written off, she cannot find a good man. Now look at the reverse. The reverse is now something that is now pouring, you know, shame, humiliation to him. I don't want to also know if at that point they had any agreement or not, but what is in vogue now, or what is current, is that Queen has found her man. A man has boldly taken the step to take Queen as a wife, and he's proud of her with his full chest. And not just only the Queen, the baby as well. okay, you can see the man, you know, giving insights and speech on how bonded he has been with the baby all along. This is a man who truly loves a woman. Some people say, I cannot have anything to do with a single mother. It is because you don't genuinely love the woman. If you genuinely love the woman or the lady, you will love her and love everything about her. The same thing goes to the woman. If you genuinely love a man, you will love him and love everything about him, even though he's a single father or he's a baby daddy, whatever. You will not just love him, you will also love him and love the children. What if the man's wife died in the process as a result of their marriage and he wants to remarry? You as a woman will also learn to love the man and love his children. This is where I want us to balance this whole thing. Just as it goes to the man, it should go to the woman, because it is not just a man's duty to accept the woman and the baby. It is also a woman's duty that is coming into the relationship or marriage to learn to accept the man for whom he is and the baby. Based on the fact that he's a good man, a man with good character, a man with good virtue, a man that is loving, a man that is caring, a man that has all it takes to wife you, to treat you as a woman and as a mother. Okay? So all these things we are saying boils down to individual differences, their character, their mindset, their perception to love and relationship. Now the lesson to learn from this whole story to every man is, if you find a good woman, don't waste time. Once your instinct, your spirit, your soul, and your body tells you that this woman is the right person for you and everything about her is aligning to it, go as fast as possible and wife her. That time you're wasting, the next man within split seconds can come, you know, within months, and you know, study her few period, get married to her before your eyes, just like what happened to Lord Lamba. Why did it take so long for Lord Lamba to waste all the time? Because I see him as a sadist. As somebody who is toxic, you don't want a woman, you don't want to wife her. She's not good enough for you to be married, to be, you know, made public, but she's good enough for you to go in between her legs, right? Come out and produce a baby. That is why everybody is even lashing on him. That's why everybody is bitter and angry with him, not because of anything. So it's a lesson for all men to learn. If you love a woman and you know she has the character and everything you want as a man, even if not everything, because not every woman is perfect, for the ones you have seen that is higher and greater, take for those ones and, you know, put a ring on her, do the needful and settle down with her. And to every woman out there, no woman deserves less. Every woman, whether you're a single mother, whether you're a widow, no matter your age, no matter your size, you are beautiful the way you are. You have a man right out there that wants to meet with you, that wants to settle down with you, that will love to be with you for the rest of his life. Don't look down on yourself because you think you have a baby now and all has ended. Keep doing what is right and being the best version and character of yourself. At the right time, the right man will come to you, okay? So guys, we've come to this phase and I will see if after now we'll come up with more updates. Thank you so much if you watched up till now. I still remain your one and only Chivik Inspirations. And if you're yet to join this family, please subscribe by hitting the subscribe button. Turn on your post notification for more interesting videos like this. And remember to always stay happy, safe, and blessed. Like, come up here on this Facebook. For now, do have a lovely day out there. Bye, guys.